On the move, a new report has recorded property sales in regional Australia increased by 20% in 2020. That's double the amount seen in the state's capitals. Data also shows in the 12 months leading up to the end of January, house prices across regional Australia surged by 40%.
Now, the big move comes as no surprise as the pandemic forced businesses to adopt working from home arrangements. This, along with lifestyle changes, have inspired Aussies to flee the concrete jungle and seek greener pastures. Social researcher and demographer Mark McCrindle joins us. Nice to see you, Mark, as always. Now, we just heard the pandemic is a contributing factor. What are some of the other reasons that Aussies are heading out of the cities?
Yeah, well, it's been a long aspiration of Australians to leave the big smoke and go bush. Particularly over the last few decades, we've seen this tree change and sea change in increasing numbers, largely for lifestyle reasons. The congestion of the cities, the business is a bit too much for many, and they're seeking the lifestyle of the regions, plus affordability. The housing affordability is far better in the bush than in the cities, and that's been a big driver. But the biggest change has been COVID and working from home. Right. And suddenly you could keep your city job, work in the new place, commute in, maybe one day a week, and so that really was a game changer.
So the pandemic numbers are coming down, vaccines are being introduced. Will this trend continue, Mark, or will it stop?
Yeah, it will continue because both the lifestyle and the affordability benefits of the regional areas will remain, and plus working from home is here to stay. You know, even though it might be in a hybrid capacity, we'll go back to the office a bit, but if you can work from anywhere, then people are going to choose to work from where they really want to live, and that doesn't have to be close to the CBD anymore.
So long term, is this the start of the urban spread, like beyond the city? Is this the start of it now?
It is the start of it. You know, we're becoming increasingly capital city centric for 200 years.
Right.
One in five Australians lives in Melbourne. Another one in five lives in Sydney. We really are congested. And we're starting to rebalance that population now. That's why the growth of the regions is above that of our capital cities. Our capital cities mainly have been growing through overseas migration. That's been stopped. We're now flooding out of our cities and getting a bit more balance. And with that will come infrastructure and development of the regions, which will attract more people.
There's some catching up to do in that department, isn't
there? Yeah, there is.
And what does that mean for the big cities, therefore? How does that impact on them?
Well, you know, cities, I think, will reinvent themselves. At the moment, it's about the central business district, and the business part is not what it once was if people are working from home. But cities like Sydney and Melbourne, they've got, you know, 200 years of infrastructure. They've still got that aspiration of what a big city brings. They'll reinvent themselves with more residential, more entertainment, be a dining precinct, be more of a destination to come into, not just an office and become ghost towns after hours.
So are there any downsides to rural properties being snapped up?
Well, there are for those that are trying to live there and maybe on lower wages in the region, just trying to, you know, hold down their normal life. Suddenly they're being priced out. Renters in the regions are suddenly finding it tough as people bring their capital city jobs and salaries and bring that to the regions. But it does raise the regions as well. There's more money to be spent. There's population, which means more demand. So it's got benefits for the regions long term, even though there's short term sort of challenge for those living there.
Sure.
Mark, always fascinating to talk to you. Thanks so much.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you, Mark. We'll be